Morning, ladies and gentlemen. Now we start so-called lectures part of our working day. And first, I should like to introduce you technology to convert food to energy. But main attention I should like to turn to German and thermochemical conversion. During last year, strong interest for biomass gasification topic has been emerged in our country from one side, and much efforts for development of gasifiers has been done in the world from other side. Of course, the following I try shortly and slightly to introduce this field in my presentation. And topics today, very short, I show you what I mean about the biomass energy chain, then opportunities to convert food and use it in energy, and then thermochemical conversion of biomass and much attention to wood, wood gas and wood gasifiers, CHPs running on wood gas, and some lovely pictures about automobiles running on wood gas. Biomass chain, my mind started from cultivating, harvesting and gathering. Then next step is processing, transport and storage, and then conversion. And we can see here three main parts of conversions. This is thermochemical, physical chemical and biochemical conversion. And on the thermochemical conversion, we mean carbonization, pyrolysis, and gasification. And then we get the solids, liquid and gaseous products, or fuels, what we can directly combust, or thermomechanical, via thermomechanical conversion, we can get electricity, motor fuels, and so on. And, three opportunities to convert food and use it to energy. As I said already, physical mechanical conversion of food is followed by treatment and combustion, and can be used in ordinary simple fireplaces and sophisticated energetical furnaces. Next is biochemical conversion of food or wood waste, and by the result of this, we can get the so-called next generation biofuels. And the last one, about I will tell you a little bit more, this is a thermochemical conversion of food. This is a decomposition. Right, so here you see some pictures about fuels that we can get after the physical mechanical conversion. There is wood chips from belly residues, wood briquettes, log fuels, and there's a little sheave of warehouse, and there's a ordinary fireplace. This is a very simple and cheap technology. And about biochemical conversion, we don't say anymore, nothing. But now the thermochemical conversion, these processes such as gasification, pyrolysis, and carbonization, we can transform this solid biofuels into solid, liquid, and gaseous secondary energy carriers, and we can use for this heat. And you see some main reaction occur. During conversion of biomass at high temperature, three main products are forming. First is gas, next is bio-oils, and third is char. And bio-oil and tar, we put together gases, oils, and char. And on the right picture, it's a very research and carbon oxide and so on. And gasification. Within the thermochemical gasification, solid biomass or solid biofuels are preferably converted into gaseous energy carriers. The process may be viewed the combustion-like conversion, but of less oxygen available than needed for burning. Excess air is open the tool up to 2.4. This means that up to 40% of oxygen or air needed for complete burning is given. And this is the region where the main wood mass transferred to the gas. The goal in gasification is to break down by variety of forms into simple fuel gases, hydrogen and carbon monoxide. And reduce gas may alternatively also be further converted into liquid gases and secondary energy carriers, like methanol, fissile drops, oil, bio-SNG, that we can use in transport sector. And here is the processes, but you can see during the gasification process, first stage is drying, pyrolysis, combustion, and reduction. And after that, we get the hydrogen and CO2. And you said that gasification is like the chill, combustion, or operating system of fire. And you see the chemical reaction of combustion through this process, CO2 is reduced to CO, and H2O is reduced to hydrogen and CO. And combustion gas become fuel gases again, and those fuel gases can then be feed to the consumers. Gas quality. The gas produced by gasification of biomass called the medium quality gas, with a liquid value or heating value is within 10 to 18 megajoules. And this gas may be used directly in the auto or diesel engines. It may be used to drive the compressors or heat pumps, for instance, and it can be upgraded for pipeline quality too, for conversion method. Pyrolysis. For pyrolysis, solid biomass are treated exclusively by the use of thermal energy with a goal to maximize the share of the liquid products. Gasification for the gaseous products and here for the liquid products. Pyrolysis is so-called dry distillation or retorting or cracking. The equivalence ratio or excess air is very, very low, below 0.1. And that kind of gasification is so-called pyrolysis. And only a small part of the energy will turn to the gaseous product. After this noise and charge. Biomass begins to fast decompose with once its temperature rises above 240 centigrades, and typically takes place the temperature over 400 degrees centigrade. And the word pyrolysis comes from three words. Pyr is fire and lysis is explosion. Pyrolysis process of cool begin at temperature 200, from 200 up to 300 centigrades, and biomass breaks down into a combination of solids, liquid and gases. Solids that remain commonly is called the char coal. And the gases and liquids together it's named the jars. And thus in review, pyrolysis is the application of heat to biomass in the absence of air.